My name is Ted Bone. I'm with Argonne National Laboratory. We're here in the Electrified Powertrain Renewable Fuels Lab. We're going to use the vehicles and facilities in this lab space to describe charging installation and charging infrastructure. All electric vehicles, or plug-in electric vehicles, have a level one charger in the trunk of the vehicle, which has a level one AC connector on one side and a level two AC connector, the J1772, on the output side that is compatible with the connector on the vehicle. These are wall-mounted, such that there's two very large mounting screws or more to screw it to the wall. The cover needs to be removed to access the internals. Inside are the AC input block, where you can see the two AC mains and the earth ground, and the output wires are pre-wired. The Leviton unit has a different approach, that it uses a pre-installation base plate that's screwed to the wall, and it has dowel pins on the back that snap into the base plate. It also is pre-wired with a NEMA 6-20 240-volt 20-amp connector that normally has a lockable enclosure over the plug as another way to meet the National Electrical Code. Inside, you can see there's no user terminals needed. It's a very simple, straightforward enclosure. Their environment unit is also wall-mounted, has convenience hooks on it to allow the electrician to hang the front panel down below as he makes the internal connections to the AC mains and the earth ground. The power feed can come in from the bottom or from the rear, depending on how things are mounted. And has a O-ring on the front to seal it. And as you can see, not much electronics inside for all the safety interlocks. These are non-intelligent charge stations, which do not have an RFID or other way of doing billing. So these are direct on-off. There's a lot of confusion about level 1, level 2, level 3 AC versus level 1, level 2, level 3 DC and world harmonization of standards. We saw the level 2 connector for most charge stations in the United States. So most charge stations in the United States will use the SAE J1772 level 2 AC connector, which is up to 80 amps if you have an appropriately sized cable. This cable is sized for 30 amps. The connector has the basic 5 pins of the main power, the earth ground, the pilot wire, which governs the amount of current that the charger can draw, and the proximity pin, which is the interlock to make sure that the power is removed before the connector is extracted. In the United States, we use single-phase power for both level 1 and level 2. And, of course, level 3 AC is 480 volts. So level 1 is 120, level 2 is 240, level 3 AC is 480 volts. If any of you are looking at Nissan vehicles, they use the Japanese Jari connector. And so this is JEVS G105 1993, which has two pins that are 150 amps and 10 and 8 interlock pins, so 10 total. This is going to be superseded by a combination of the DC and the AC to simplify the process. And that's how the world is harmonizing on AC standards and combined with DC standards. And this is level 2 DC. So what you'll see is level 2 home, level 2 public infrastructure, and then level 2 DC, which is up to 200 amps. Level 3 DC is 400 amps. And level 1 DC, which is unknown to most people, will also use this and use the communication pin to facilitate using the existing connector up to 32 kilowatt on this 42 millimeter connector. So in general, harmonization within the globe between the US, Europe, China, and Japan is ongoing. And in the United States, we've settled on the SAE J1772 level 2 connector for 240 volts and the combination connector for level 2 DC and level 2 AC. Some confusion out there about the difference between charging stations and chargers and the thing that you're charging, which are batteries. So in all electric vehicles, there are electrochemical energy storage systems with a battery management system on top of each card that tells the charger, which is this unit or this unit, how much DC power to take from the AC lines and put into the battery. So this system of the charger and the battery management system govern the amount of electricity that goes into the batteries. For a 24 kilowatt hour vehicle, charging at 3 kilowatt would be 6 plus hours of charging. For smaller vehicles, it would be less. And of course, for a plug-in hybrid vehicle, which might have a 4 to 6 to 8 kilowatt hour capacity, it would be in the 3 to 6 hour range. Inside the charger, there's sophisticated electronics to convert the AC power into DC power. along with the communication to the battery management system. These can be air-cooled or liquid-cooled. The measurement system of AC power is usually done off-board. Some units have a metering circuit inside of it. Some units have an external one that is owned by the utility. Much like the regular full-size meter, it has a submeter. Submetering is an important part of the smart grid and the way utilities can bill out energy that is distributed to the electric car separate from energy that is delivered to the rest of the residents or to the business.